Hey, Nora, what's up?
Hey, Maisie. Sorry to call so late, but I'm just so worried for the AP Calc test in 2 weeks. I mean, it just came up so fast, you know?
Yeah, I know what you mean. Like, I've worked really hard. I've been going through all my test prep books over and over again, and I'm still so nervous.
Yeah, I mean, I'm so stressed out that I see Calc everywhere I look.
Yeah, it's the weirdest thing. Like, my sister handed me a banana the other day, and I was like, oh my gosh, it's a parabola.
That's crazy.
I know.
We should definitely get a study group together this weekend. What do you think?
Sounds like a good idea. Yeah, definitely. I'll call OK Michaela and Harold up.
Okay. Then we should probably meet at Rock and Joe's like we did last time. That was a really good spot.
Sounds good.
Gosh, I'm so sick of doing all this calc work.
Me too.
Have you been staying for hours? Can you watch some TV?
Yeah, sure. Are you having trouble in AB calculus? Then you need to take Abdulhadi Axafil. Abdulhadi Axafil is guaranteed to at least help you do better on the AB calculus exam than you would on your own.
After taking Abdulhadi Axafil, I started getting 40% instead of 20% on my AP exams.
Side effects may include crying, lower GPA, nausea, 3 hours of homework, bleeding, pop quizzes, constantly checking Edmodo, and sometimes death. Don't take this if you want to be valedictorian or want an A average. Talk to your guidance counselor if you are thinking about taking Abdulhadi Axafil. If you experience any of these side effects, drop the class. Oh wait, you can't. Good luck.
Hello, my name is Harold Afori.
And I'm Michaela Patillo, and welcome to Channel Pi News. Just in, mass hysteria has broken out amongst AB Calc students in the Maplewood South Orange School District. Reports have shown that students are having severe mental breakdowns after walking into Mr. Abdulhadi's Calc class and witnessing a picture of Michael Jackson along with the phrase, pop quiz, on the board.
Now, here's some live footage with our field reporter, Nora Murray.
Hi, Nora. How's it going out there?
Hi, Michaela. I'm currently standing outside of Mr. Abdulhadi's classroom at the scene of mass hysteria following the pop quiz.
Hello, my name is Harold Afori, and I'm at the library right now on an expedition to observe the natural habitat of calc snakes. Come on.
Alright guys, here we have the wild okeechukwu. He's supposed to be studying right now, but the wild okeechukwu is usually a procrastinator, a very interesting creature. But as I can tell, he's not fit for survival because he's not studying. Guys, let's move on to the next creature. Alright guys, look, we found a rare creature. I'll call her the Nora. Look, she's using her phone very wisely by using the app Cam Scanner to upload her extra credit onto Edmodo. She's definitely fit for survival if she stays on this right track. Alright guys, I think we have time for one more creature. Let's go. Okay, look. We just found an extremely rare creature. The ferocious Michaela. And right now, she's in her devastated face. She's broken down. She's weary. She's crying. And I don't think she can make it all the way to the AP exam. Guys, let's have a closer look. She's bawling. They have been known to attack people, so they have to be very quiet. Alright guys, we just escaped. Well, this is the end of the show, guys. But tune in next week for more Danger Calc. Alright, out.
Oh man, calculus is so hard.
Yeah, I know.
Watch this. Like a good tutor, Tuckman is there.
And Nora, what do you need help with?
Antiderivatives.
No problem.
Welcome back to Channel Pi News. My name is Haruto Fori. Now here's an update on our developing story about the mass hysteria surrounding local Calc students.
I
am
a
Calc survivor. So when I walked into the classroom, I just became so distraught. I saw Michael Jackson's face sitting up on the board and I knew he was just mocking me the entire time. I knew I was gonna fail. Thank you.
The second I walked in, I knew that pop quiz was directed at me for that sass I gave him last week.
It was no big deal. I passed that.
I stay awake at night, just going over my mistakes again and again and again. I could just do it one more time. I would get it this time. I know.
At least it's over now.
Hello, this is OK Foods with your host, OK. Today our guest star is Nora.
Hi, OK. Thank you for having me on the show. Today I'm going to show you how to bake a five. Going to want to do is complete all your homework. There you go, all 3 hours worth of problems. Secondly, you're going to want to complete your smileys on every test so that you can go over all the problems that you made mistakes on. Now, thirdly, you should probably watch some Khan Academy videos to really focus on areas where you're not too good.
I watch those all the time.
Alright, next, you should really study from your Barron's test prep book. That's gonna help a lot. And finally, the most important ingredient of all is to really memorize that Memorize Me sheet. Now if you mix all these ingredients together, you're sure to get a 5 on that AB calculus exam.
Alex Trebek, welcome back to Jeopardy. Now let's go back to Michaela.
Sounds for 300?
What is the sound Mr. Abdahadi makes when you lose participation points?
Correct, Harold. Now ask the next one.
Helpful tools for 100?
The place Mr. Abdahadi's students go to check daily notes.
What is Edmodo?
Tune back in later for Final Jeopardy.
This has been OK Foods. Tune in next week for the next episode.
Alright, OK. Would you like a piece of this five?
Yes. It's calculicious.
Yes.
So when I first came to the scout class, I was really struggling. Like, it seemed really difficult to me because I felt really behind. I had only just taken my trig course over the summer before I started this class. It felt like I was so behind because I hadn't taken a full pre-calc class. And as time went on, I just wanted to push through and pull through and get a great grade on the AP test, but it seemed like things weren't going well at all. I wasn't getting any good grades and things like that. And I was really struggling with material, but I decided to push through, and then at some point I thought that maybe I would drop out and go to regular, like, honors calc, because one of my friends had. Yeah, at that point it was too late to drop out, so I just had to stick with it and pull through, and things started to get a little better, but it was still a big struggle.
This class was a very interesting experience. Although the class might seem very hard, if you keep up with homework and tests and quizzes, and you actually study for them and come after school, the class could become much easier. First marking quarter, I didn't come after school to visit him, so that's the reason why my grades suffered to begin with. Doing your homework really affects how you perform on the tests and quizzes that you do, because you might get a lot of homework, but the homework really does prepare you for the tests and quizzes, because it's pretty much exactly what's on these exams.
So when I first joined this class, I didn't really know what to expect, but I kind of grew to like it. To be honest, at the beginning of the year, like, I wasn't studying as much as I should have, and that kind of held me back. So I had to, in addition to homework, study more. And I felt that really helped me, like, grasp the basics and, like, notice patterns in the calc work. So later on, like, it definitely helped me out because I thought I had a pretty good foundation. There are also some days in the middle of the year that I missed, and those are some pretty major days. So Edmodo helped me out, or just talking to my classmates and asking for help helped out a lot.
Well, going into this class, I knew it was going to be challenging, but I didn't know that it would be this challenging. So there was a bit of a misconception there, but I think throughout the year, I was very diligent with my homework, and I did it a lot, making sure that I was on top of things. Kind of keeping on top of those things, such as homework, Edmodo, and all the extra credit assignments, really helped me sort of develop these skills and get a little closer to mastering them than I probably would have had I not done my homework or any of those other activities. The Baron books were pretty helpful. Forming study groups and sort of working on your own was really crucial to doing well in this class, and I think that all of the pre-testing and all of the drilling that we did was really helpful, even though a lot of us didn't like it. Like with the pop quizzes, like none of us liked the pop quizzes, but I think they made us prepare a little bit better.
This was definitely the most challenging math class I've ever taken. But I don't know if that was because the work was hard or because I just had a really hard time balancing this workload with my other AP classes. I know I didn't have good study habits, so the retakes definitely helped me a lot because I was able to just study all my mistakes on the first test and do better the second time. Overall, I wish I had started studying for the exam a lot earlier than I did. I bought a study book in February and didn't open it until spring break. I don't regret taking this class. I think it has prepared me in some ways for college next year.
This is OK Foods with OK Cakes.
Hi, OK. Thank you for having me on the show. Today I'm going to show you how to bake a five. The first thing you're going to want to do, you just walk away! Now if you mix all these ingredients, you're sure to get a five on that eight.
Damn! To observe. Stop.
Ah! The dog can't jump that high, right? Like a good dude.
Witnessing. Ooh, is witnessing a real witnessing?
Right now, I'm standing outside Mr. Abdulhadi's classroom.
We're all confused. We're all very confused.
I am a calc survivor.